Good morning. It basically shows I've been around a long time and I've done a lot of different things. But first of all, I can't be up here without welcoming you here to our center. This is, first, it's a great group of you. It was a pleasure to stand back here and have you all introduce yourselves. And you all follow the rules. So I'm sure Porcia's very happy. I've never seen that done so well before. Someone always gives the commercial, right? At some point in the day. So you guys did great, but what an impressive group. This is exactly what we want these centers to be used for. And so we're pleased that we're doing it. This is a reflection of the family's mission, a reflection of the family's work, of having these hubs, of which there's three now with 70 grantees that are getting, you know, rent-free and free conference rooms for the Bear. But we're also working actively to make them more than just the space. And so you heard about that before, so I'm not going into that. But this is exactly what we're trying to do. So hopefully you can use it more and we can have more conversations like this. So I hope this is the beginning of a conversation. So a couple things real quickly. Foundations, I'm trying to be careful about. A lot of you, I saw the meet and greet where you just had to come out and meet me. So I'm not gonna go down the whole foundation litany, but for those that weren't there and don't know about the foundation, we have an educational program that focuses on 21st century education, promoting success and access to education, making all the kids in the Valley college ready is our goal. We have a Healthy People and Places program area that really is focusing on making sure that there's access to the basic needs of basic community safety net organizations in the Valley so that everyone has the opportunity to thrive. We have our Thriving Nonprofit program, which this is part of and our centers are part of, which is really looking at if we're gonna be a leading place-based funder, which we are, how do we help the nonprofit sector reach the level and the potential they need to do? And I talked a lot about that at my meet and greet. And then finally, probably the fourth area and the one that you guys is most relevant today is our philanthropy engagement area. The Sobrato Foundation and with the living donors and the second generation donors, we feel that we're in a very unique place and a very special place to be able to have our engaged living donors be of the age and of the wealth to talk to the people that we're all trying to reach and that you guys are all trying to reach. And so we really have had a lot of conversations and really trying to take it upon ourselves to figure out, and we don't have the answer yet, but to figure out what can Lisa Cecina Sobrato, what can her brother, what can the son-in-laws, what can they do? How can they talk to their colleagues, their friends, their peer group? How can we engage them and really create a culture of philanthropy? So we're really excited about that. That's gonna be a journey that we're gonna undertake with many of you and by ourselves trying to figure that out. This is the beginning of a conversation that we need to have about that, but we're committed to that as part of our effort to be seen in this place as a leader and a critical voice. So when I got the themes or the theories, I was torn. The three that were listed, they all have some relevance, I don't think it's important for us to minimize any of them, but the question was, which one do I want to go forward? And I couldn't do that. So unlike other, you guys that follow the rules correctly, I couldn't do that. I think the ones that you'll hear me talking about a lot in my tenure here has it really do with the expectation of donors. I think that's shifted. I'm looking out and I see one of my original mentor, the one that gave me my first job in the field, Bart Charlotte, out there, so I thank him for that. You guys should thank him for that, otherwise I wouldn't be here. But the tours that we used to do and the things that we used to do to bring people in to see what we were doing, those don't work anymore. And it's a different level of expectation. Having someone come in and see that you've delivered, in those cases, you know, 500 of this or 1,000 of these, that's not the tour that's going to work. It's not going to engage the current generation. I've had a lot of talks with Lisa about this, and as she talks with her friends and colleagues, and so we're trying to figure that out. But that clearly isn't it. So something has changed. Something has changed dramatically. I do think it's the advent of the internet. I do think that it's the fact that they now believe in this global scale, this different kind of scale. But I wanted to put that out there, and we'll talk more about that in the question. This whole issue of the way that we present our problem, the way we present our work, has changed in a different way for this different generation. And then I said, well, that's good, and I'm okay with that. But the other thing that's really interesting for me, and I think we should talk about, is the social poverty issue. Rebranding, the fact that people don't appreciate that there is a level of poverty in the valley. So I think those two are kind of